How do you know what form to make in Dubsado? I'm going to tell you in today's video. This is the YouTube channel for all things Dubsado CRM. My name is Ray, and welcome to the Productive Co YouTube channel. If you want video tutorials on how to use Dubsado, make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel because I talk exclusively about using Dubsado in your business. When I first started using Dubsado, I wasn't sure if I should build out a lead capture, a questionnaire, a proposal, when I should use subagreements. I had no idea what kind of form I was supposed to build out. In this video, I'm uncovering what you need to know so that you can build out the correct form in Dubsado. In order to access forms in Dubsado, you will log into the interface, and on the left side under templates, you will select forms. Forms is just another word for documents. So you have a section here for emails and a section here for packages, but all of your documents are going to go into forms. And there are five different form types in Dubsado. There are contracts, so that requires a signature. There are subagreements, which are like secondary contracts. In Dubsado, you can only have one primary contract. So if you need to add multiple contracts to a job, you would make those subagreements. So subagreements also require a signature. Then there's questionnaires. Now the name is a little misleading because you can actually ask questions in any single form. And you don't have to ask questions in questionnaires. You can actually upload JPEGs. Maybe it's a welcome packet, so you're just providing information. You don't actually have to ask questions. But this is good for anything that doesn't require a signature and is not a formal price quote and is not a contact form. So your formal price quotes are actually going to go in proposals. Now, proposals are extra unique. They can be 1 to 3 pages long. And the first page is going to be your proposal. This is where you tell the client how much you want to charge them, and you can provide a variety of other information like your office hours, how excited you are to work with them, what your policies are, etc. If you go into settings, you can choose to add a contract, which would be the second page, and you can choose to add an invoice, which would be the third page. So you could potentially send a proposal that's just the quote, but you can also send it with a contract and or an invoice. That way, if a client approves your price quote, they can sign the contract and pay you right then and there. So remember that proposals are formal price quotes and they can be bundled documents. Then there's lead captures. Lead captures are your contact forms. Your client should only have to fill it out once for every project they do with you. So one of the mistakes that I see being made is sometimes people don't know if something should be a questionnaire or a lead capture. And the answer is they should only fill out the lead capture once, and that's generally the very first point of contact they have with you. So when they fill out the lead capture, Dubsado creates a new client profile for you. So if you've already got the profile made and you want to ask them some more questions, you would send them a questionnaire. So your lead capture is your contact form. Now, if you want in on a secret about Dubsado forms, I will link to another video that talks to you about a form hack that will make your life so much easier. Now, if you build out the wrong form, that's no problem at all. I have another video on how to fix that will save you so much time. So I'll link to that up above for your convenience. If you have any questions, pop them down in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up so I know you liked it. Thanks for stopping by today. I'll see you around.